Hello students, so today we will discuss about forms in MS Access. We will discuss about forms with the same table which we have used to describe the data types and their properties in our last video, okay, the employee detail. So before starting our discussion, let us know what you mean by forms. Forms is a way through which a user can enter data, update and delete the data also. Okay, now these are mainly used by those people who don't have much idea about the database, about how to create the database, what are the main concepts behind the database. They are the people who are there only for entering and doing any type of modification in the data. Okay, for example, if you go to any type of shopping mall or any place where they have a software and the people sitting who is responsible for entering the data, What they do? They just insert the data, they do any type of updation, deletion and all this type of work. They don't go in details inside the database, how is the structure of the database, what type of data you can store here. All these things has been already defined by the database creator. Okay, so the person who will create the database may not be the person who is responsible for entering the data. So if you create the form, then it will be very user friendly for a general people to enter data and do any type of manipulation or modifications in the data in the database. Okay, so for that, let us begin how we can create the form. Now in MS Access, there are three ways through which we can create the form. Before that, let us just revise what we have done in the employee details table. So this is the employee detail design view. We have these fields, okay. These fields were just for your to understand what is the use of the AAD object attachment hyperlink, which we have used our last video, okay. So in employee ID, this one I have used as a primary key text, then employee name, text, memo, date, time, text, currency. Then graduate, yes or no, we have already discussed what is the meaning of these data types. OLE, object attachment hyperlink. So you may have confused about OLE object and attachment. So this confusion will also be cleared in our when we will show you how the data are stored in the forms. Okay, so first of all, to create a form, what we have to do now, for each and every table we have to create different forms. Okay, now this is the one, only one table is there in this database. So I will click on the table. Okay, so you will have to click on the table for which you will create the form. Okay, so I have created the click on the table, then I will go to the create button. Okay, so in the create button, what I will do here, you have this part, forms, split form, multiple form. There are other parts, different types of forms are also there. Form wizard, data sets, model dialog, keyboard table. Okay, now one by one I will explain. So you have to create a form, you click on the table. So what is written here? Table or query needed in order to create a new form. Report or query is currently open in design view. So save or discard change in this table or query and open it in data seed view, then try it later. So if you have opened a design view, then you cannot create a form. For this, you have to go either in the open view. Okay, so this was the our data in the employee ID table. Some of the values we have already entered here. So let us, this one fix we have to do. Let us write some value here. Whatever data you want to enter here, all these things are resolved. Now these are the data. Okay, now I click on the But then now I will go to the form, create a form. Okay, so this is, see, automatically this form has been already created. So employee ID, whatever data we have entered here, this is, see here in the part here is showing here record 1 of 3. Means you have already 3 records. This is the first record of the total 3 records. So whose first record is E01, E02, Ankit, ZZZ. So this was the thing. Here if you want to, here see, we don't have any value here. Okay, so if you want to enter from here, how we can enter, I will show you one by one. Let us create a new one. So if you click in this one arrow, it will go to the next field. If you click another, it will go to the next field like this. Okay, so 4 is empty because we have not entered, but 4 I have clicked here. So you can enter new value also from here. What we can do is that I will the layout view. Okay, so what we have to do, you have to go to the form view. Okay, to enter the data in the form view, your third number is there, fourth number I want to enter E05, then employee name, let it be Roshi, then address, let it be the date of joining. See here also date comes. So let it be like designation is for network administrator. Okay, salary let it be 30,000. See is graduate or not. Okay, then here see it was an OLA object. What we have to do to enter the data here, you have to just right click here, insert object. Okay, whatever object you want to enter, either a bitmap object, okay, either a Microsoft graph, or whatever object you want, either a worksheet, document, any type of thing you can enter. So if you click on bitmap object, what will happen? See, click here, okay. Bitmap object means the object which we create in the Paint software, and like this type of software. Here you just can write anything here. It's for example, it's a log. Okay. Now you click on save and close it. See, it came here. Now this one was for the attachment. Okay, this one is a OL. Okay, another one I will tell you. And this one was, this field was for the attachment. See, here this field was for ABC, was for the OLA object, and this field was for the attachment object. So for that, what we can do, just you have to click here and you have to edit. So what type of field, for example, we have edit, so it came here automatically. So same thing here also, you are inserting a different file in this MS Access. Here also you are inserting, but the way of inserting is different. Okay, here also you can enter any type of PDF file, document, anything. So email ID, if I write here, okay, so like this you will click on save. Okay, so when you click on save, it is asking for what you want to give the name of the form. Let it be employee details only. If you want to change it, you can also change the employee details. I have changed to employee details form. So you click here. Like this you can enter another new record. 5 here. Like this you can enter. Okay. Now I will show you how to create a form using the split form option. So similarly, this was for our table employee detail. This is the form which we have created for the form option. Again, we will show you how to create using split form. Okay, so click here, go to the create. Here you have split form, click here. Same thing, like the form only, but here you have two ways of showing the data. One is a form view, another is a data sheet. Okay, whatever you will enter here, it will become automatically here. So one, E05, I have shown you how to enter the field for OLA object and attachment and email also hyperlink. Okay, now in this way, I will show you different types of file here. Okay, let it be you have to click on the, this is a layout view, okay? To enter the data, what you have to do, view form view card. So here 205, is this a way, this one is, I think it's a better way. If you can see all the data which I have entered here, okay? To see E05 is there, E06 I will enter. Then name I'm giving here, village. Okay, so let me press the smile. Then date of joining. Again, you can change the date of joining. Click here, you can change the date of joining. Okay. And then this is only salary 5000. Okay, not graduate. So it was the OLE object. But for the OLE object, same thing, what you have to do? Insert object. Now, for example, this is for, I will end. This is for one document I want to enter here. So click here and click on OK. So here you see, here you can create a document also and can enter. Okay, so hello, my name is. So this type of file you want to enter, this was the file. But in attachment, see, attachment, if you want to attach any file, you can make the attachment outside the applications, this MS Access, and then you can attach it. But in a OLE object, you can also create and attach at the same time. Now this one DVD was for attachment. Click here, add. So here, this time again, I will show you, you want to enter some documents. Let it be one PDF file. So okay, click here, see this PDF file. If you want to open it, what you have to do, just click here, then open. Okay, it will open here. Okay, here open. It will open like this. Okay. So, email ID also. So here you have used a data type as hyperlink. So that's why it came here as hyperlink. So now you click on save. Okay. Okay. Click here. This one is another table. Form, and it's using the split option. That's why this another form is created. This is the form which we have created from the general form option, and this is the form which we have created from the split option. Clear? So this way we may add the data using the forms. Okay. Now if you want to make any changes here, what we can do? For example, this is the one of four. This is a 5 of 4, 5 something, 5. We do sheet then. Oh, this one was a okay. Okay, student. I think you have understood how to enter the value with the help of the form. Okay, now by mistake here in E01, I have saved it as E02 because I have not used a new record. Again, I will show you how to create a new record here using the split option only. So this for new record, you can also write click here, new blank record. Okay, you can click here or you can just go to the blank here and you enter any value E07. Data join designation Salary. It's an OID object. Click here inside the object. This is, for example, this is our company's logo you want to write. And here for the OLE object, we want to add any pictures of our ADP. This one. Okay. And for the, any picture you want to save here. Okay, and email ID. Here, now you will click here on save. Okay, you can click here also, or you can click here on the save button. Okay, save. Okay, so last option was how to create form using the form wizard. Similarly, go to table, go to create here in this more forms. You click here, you go to form wizard. In form wizard, this type of way, another window gets open. Here, you have the means option that you can in your form, you can choose which field you want to include in the form. Here in the previous version, all the fields were included automatically, but here you can choose which field you want to include. Here, if I want to include all the things, you just click here, you just click here, it will go there. If you don't want it, you click here, it will go. So, if you click here in double, this greater than symbol, double one, all will go there. If you click here, all will go this side. So, I want this all the table. If you want to change the name of the table, okay, from which table you want to create employee details, and then next columnar view, tabular view, different options are here. You can just try dataset view will just come as a dataset justified tabular view. Okay, now you can have you can choose different options here. You can choose anything access remove and create different options are here. So next, then you can give the name here, name of your form. From one I have created. Open the form to view and or enter information and modify the form's design. You want to modify the design, you can design it, go back and finish it, and click here. Okay, and finish. See, yes, key. So different as you have chosen a different style, it is came in this way. Okay, so if you want to enter a new value, you enter here like this, it will come. So which one is easy or comfortable to you, you can choose any other form option and can enter the data. Okay, so okay students, that's all for today. So if you have doubt regarding the how to create a form, why we use form, okay, you can just comment me in my comment box and just try to do it yourself in practically in your computer. Okay, that's all for today. Bye, and see you in our next video.